to Exploring the Opportunity Atlas. The Opportunity Atlas is a free online mapping tool that uses big data to explore the impact that neighborhoods have on the children growing up in them. It's designed for city, state, and federal government workers.
Like me. I work in city government, and my team and I are always looking to use data to make our work stronger.
Like you, as well as policymakers, community leaders, and researchers, really anyone interested in making their city more equitable. In this course, you'll learn how to use the Atlas to identify which neighborhoods in America offer children the best chance to rise out of poverty. You'll understand which characteristics drive the best long-term outcomes for children on a national level, and how to identify economic trends in cities and neighborhoods. You'll also see how people are using the Atlas to create policies and programs to improve their communities. There are four modules in this course. Module one, preparing to use the Opportunity Atlas, focuses on the data behind the Atlas and provides the foundational concepts you'll need to use it effectively. Module two, using the Opportunity Atlas, defines key features of the Atlas and teaches you how to engage with the data. Module three, exploring national patterns on the local level, is a step-by-step guide for using the Atlas to explore neighborhood characteristics that may help explain different outcomes for children and low-income families. And Module 4, a case study for using the Atlas for local housing policy, explores a real-world example of how people are using the Atlas to support housing policy and increase mobility for low-income children in Seattle.
Sounds great. Who are you again? And why did you create the Opportunity Atlas?
We're Opportunity Insights, a nonpartisan, not-for-profit organization at Harvard University. Our research is motivated by the concept of the American Dream, the ideal that children, regardless of background, will grow up to have a higher standard of living than their parents. Economists call this upward income mobility. Although generations of Americans have achieved the American dream, our research shows that it is increasingly out of reach. When we compare household incomes of Americans at age 30, adjusted for inflation, with their parents' household income at age 30, we find that rates of upward income mobility have fallen from approximately 90% of children born in 1940 to 50% of children born in the 1980s. And although upward income mobility rates have declined overall, there is significant variation across the country.
How does upward income mobility look in my city?
You'll be able to find the answer in just a few clicks with the Opportunity Atlas. We partnered with the U.S. Census Bureau to access anonymized data from the 2000 and 2010 censuses and federal income tax returns from the IRS from 1989 to 2015. This data set covers 96% of all children born between 1978 and 1983, more than 20 million Americans, including authorized immigrants. We mapped these children, who are adults today, to the census tract they grew up in. Then, for each of the 70,000 census tracts in America, we estimated the average adult outcomes of people who grew up there. We provide estimates for a whole range of outcomes, like average earnings, incarceration rates, and more.
So wait, 20 million people over 30 years mapped to 70,000 census tracts? That's a lot of data.
It is, but that's kind of what we do. A quick note, for the sake of simplicity, we'll just refer to census tracts as neighborhoods. It's important to remember, though, that census tracts do not always align perfectly with official neighborhood boundaries. This mapping process, along with the efforts made to protect the privacy of the individuals represented in the data, is all explained in more detail in the Opportunity Atlas, Mapping the Childhood Roots of Social Mobility, which is available on our resources page at opportunityinsights.org/atlasresources.
How is the Atlas different from existing data on poverty and inequality?
Traditional measures of poverty and neighborhood conditions only provide a snapshot of income and other variables at a given point in time.
To study how economic opportunity varies across neighborhoods, we need to observe people over many years to see how their outcomes depend upon family circumstances and where they grew up. The Opportunity Atlas is the first data set that provides that kind of information at a detailed neighborhood level.
Using the Atlas, we can trace the roots of outcomes such as household income, incarceration rates, employment rates, and college graduation rates back to where these children grew up, helping people like you create more effective policies and programs.
Okay, I'm tracking with you, but can you show me an example?
Sure. Let's start by looking at a national map that displays all the children who grew up in low-income families in our data set.
Now, let's look at the household incomes of those children as adults. While all these children begin at the same economic starting point, you can see that where they grew up had a profound effect on their upward income mobility. For example, a child who was born into a low-income family in St. Louis, Missouri, grew up to earn a household income of $23,000 on average, while a low-income child from Sacramento, California, grew up to earn just under $34,000 on average.
But wait, why is there such a difference between low-income children who grew up in St. Louis and those that grew up in Sacramento?
There's no easy answer, but the Opportunity Atlas will help you uncover important insights into the patterns and drivers of upward income mobility in different neighborhoods and cities.
One thing we know is that strong job growth in a city or community doesn't always result in upward income mobility for the children who grew up there.
Wait, what? Why is that?
Because cities can achieve high rates of economic growth by attracting people from other areas to move in and take high-paying jobs.
For example, Atlanta and Charlotte have had very high rates of job and wage growth over the past two decades, yet they have among the lowest rates of upward income mobility for individuals who grow up there. While this impressive growth may have brought other benefits to these cities, it's clear that a booming economy does not guarantee better adult outcomes for local children. Focusing only on job growth overall is unlikely to make a significant impact on upward income mobility over time without more targeted interventions that prioritize opportunity for existing community members and address opportunity inequalities.
Well, that makes perfect sense. You know, this information would be really helpful in knowing how to allocate our city budgets, like between a jobs program or industry growth incentives. What other insights have you uncovered with the Atlas?
Okay, here are three quick findings we've uncovered that have implications for public policy.
First, on the national level, adult employment rates in a given neighborhood are strongly correlated with upward income mobility for the children who grow up there. Second, upward income mobility for children is associated with other neighborhood characteristics, including average income, fraction of two-parent families, social capital, and school test scores. And third, upward income mobility rates can vary significantly by children's race and gender. When comparing the outcomes of Black children and white children who both grew up in low-income families in the same neighborhood, even on the same block, we find large differences in adult outcomes.
This tells us there are other factors affecting upward income mobility that aren't reflected in the data alone. That's why it's important to go into your neighborhoods and ask the people living there why they think certain outcomes have occurred. Combining our data with on-the-ground perspectives is essential in creating informed policies.
I'm excited. I can't wait to use the Atlas myself.
In Module 2, you'll learn how to use the Atlas to identify key factors of upward income mobility in your neighborhood and community. But before we go, the takeaways from this module are:
upward income mobility has declined significantly since 1940. Outcomes for low-income children can vary drastically from one neighborhood to another, indicating that places have an impact on children's eventual adult outcomes. And traditional indicators of the health of a local economy, like job growth, may not predict upward income mobility for children who grew up in low-income families in that community. If you want to go deeper into understanding the data behind the Atlas and our methods for creating it, you can view the methods and FAQ pages available on the bottom left-hand corner of the Atlas. All right, that's all for now. See you in Module 2 of Exploring the Opportunity Atlas.